Hey friends, it's Jacqueline here. In today's video, I'm bringing you my review and demo on the brand new Hourglass Ambient Lighting Infinity Powder. But before we get started, and if you're new here, I hope that you will consider and subscribe to my channel, ring that post notification bell so you don't miss any of my uploads, and come and follow me on my Instagram. And now, if you want to know more details about this powder, if it will work on dry, mature, and light to medium skin tone, then just keep on watching. I have said it over and over again, the thing that I love the most about Hourglass is that they come out with products in a very slow pace and very well thought out. So when I saw this new powder, I was honestly impressed because I didn't heard anything about it before. I mean, there was no hype around it, nothing. In fact, when they were kind of like a sneak peeking that something was coming up, it was for the Hourglass, the new mascara, which I ended up not picking it up. I mean, like I said, I repeated many times right here on my channel, I do have tons of mascaras, so I just feel really bad if I'm gonna grab a mascara just for grabbing it. I don't know, I just don't feel like it, okay? So when I saw that first sneak peek, I didn't know it was a mascara. I was thinking, I don't know if you remember, I mentioned it on a Will I Buy It here in my channel, this palette that it kind of looks like the ambient lighting palette, kind of like this right here, but it has what it seems like a highlighter, a blush, and a bronzer. And we haven't yet seen it. All of a sudden, they show up that it was a mascara, and then all of a sudden, without notice, on the website of Hourglass, it appeared this new powder. I'm like, where are you coming from? It's called the Ambient Lighting Infinity Powder. And this baby right here costs $50. It's made in Italy, and as you can tell, it has this, you know, very common marbleized type of powders together. I mean, we know Hourglass, how they are, right? And that's perhaps why I love about the powders from Hourglass, because there is a balance between the powders. This has a shelf life of 12 months and it has a weight of 9.5 grams of product. Now, this is a finishing powder. So let me just go ahead and read you what it says on the website of Hourglass. It says right here, 3 times that dimension, 3 times the perfection, Infinity Radiance, the first of its kind finishing powder, features 2 ambient lighting powders and 1 ambient strobe highlighter in 1 mélange, flattering the complexion with a soft focus and natural radiance. To ensure a perfect marbling of pigment and luminescence in 1 formula, they are hand blended using the micellare technique. Micellare is in Italian, is to mix in, ideal for light to medium skin tones. And that's something else that I also have criticized in the past, and I will always criticize any luxury brand and any brand overall for not really being inclusive. I mean, we have seen Hourglass coming out during the holidays with these type of palettes right here, and this is the only one. This one is the Ambient Unlock, the only one that it was suited for a light, medium tone skin tone. Like, this is suited for me. You may see me a little bit light on camera, but I have a light medium skin tone. By the way, I'm leaving all the products that I'm using on my face today on the description box below, as well as foundation, you know, the foundation that matches my skin tone, so, you know, for reference. But going back again, I mean, like, why they decide to launch just one? Why couldn't they just go ahead and launch more? Anyhow, when I open this up, what I noticed right away, it seems like it has kind of like a grayish cast on it. I mean, it looks kind of foggy. That, sincerely, that's how it looks like. It doesn't look that, you know, radiant as other powders from Hourglass. So, I mean, to be honest with you, I don't know, I'm so. We're gonna try it today and see what happens. Okay, my friends, so if you're new here, welcome to my channel. I'm super happy that you're here. And if you're already a subscriber of mine, welcome back again. Thank you so much for that love and that support. But I just wanna reiterate that the person who is doing this demo right here, I do like to wear glowy products. I like radiant foundations. I usually do not use setting powders only on my under eye area, just to, you know, set my concealer, and that's in certain cases, not always. Today I haven't. Again, I will be leaving everything that I'm using today down below. In fact, for the purpose of this video, I'm using the new Tom Ford Traceless Soft Matte Foundation, and I did a review of this product. This, you may have seen it this past Friday. I don't know when I'm gonna be uploading this video, but this past Friday I have again reviewed this product right here. Anyhow, I usually do not go for matte foundations, but this is a soft matte. It has a very natural finish. In fact, you can see right now, I mean, I have been wearing it for a few hours right now, and you can see my oils peeking through. Today's around 80s here in California. That's another thing that is super important to know when you check reviews from other people, aside to be very alike to your skin type, whether you have dry, combo skin, oily skin, you know. Not only that, don't only check for that, obviously the preference of the person who is reviewing it, but also if you can kind of dig in on what area the person who is reviewing it, you know, is trying the product, because that can alter many things. Like you say, if you're living in Florida, on the East Coast where it's more humid, products, they are gonna act differently on you. Okay, let's just stop blabbing right here. Let's go ahead and give it a whirl. I'm gonna be using my Master Face brush from Sonia G, and I'm gonna get you closer. Let's go with this red right here. I mean, it looks so pretty, right? Okay, I do have enlarged pores right here, so let's see if it blurs them out. Okay, it does have a soft focus effect. And you know what? It has mattified a little bit more the foundation. And I don't know, but it's leaving me little tiny, tiny, itsy bitsy specks of like what it seems glitter, but tiny specks, almost unnoticeable. But they are there. They are certainly there. I mean, you cannot see them. Like, if you're like perhaps like 2 steps away from me, 3 steps away from me, you're not gonna be able to see them. I don't find it to be as radiant as other powders. Now, it doesn't show on me that much, but I'm afraid that this powder has, like I said, it has kind of like this foggy, you're not gonna be able to see it on camera. I will try to put it on my Instagram to see if you can, you know, see it closely, but it looks like it has a little bit of like, kind of like a foggy cast to it. So let's go ahead and swatch these, and I'm gonna swatch it on my arm because, yeah, this is, or my hand too, because these are the darkest part of my skin. This is the lighter part of my skin. So yeah, let's do it right here. Okay, here we go. Then I'm gonna compare it to the Ambient Lighting Palette. This is one of my favorite finishing powders. So usually I use it all across the board. Oh, how I do this? Okay, I'm gonna do the, first I'm gonna do them individually. I just put this one right here. So this is the Lighting Infinity Powder. Very alike to this one right here. Okay, so. Yep. Now this one here has more luminosity than this one, and it seems like this one is even a little bit cooler in tone than this on my skin tone. This has just a dash more champagne in it, and then let's just go across the board and do kind of like, you know, a mix. And I'm just gonna put it above. Okay, and now let's go for the Ambient Unlock palette. This is, again, this is a limited edition item, but if you have it, I think it's might as well worth it to try it. These two are the finishing powders. This is a bronzer, so I'm just gonna put them right here and right here. You can barely see this one. This one is more deep. Just going to this one right here. and I'm gonna just put it in between. Yeah, this has a little bit more champagne in it. And you know what? Now I want to compare it to the new YSL. This is the Touche Croix 3D All Over Glow. And this has been my favorite finishing powder lately. I have been using it non-stop. But this one right here, you see, has more of like, you know, like a peachy undertone to it. Where I should put it? Okay, so I just want to, again, compare it. So I'm just going to go... Where? I'm going to go down here. And then, I mean, once again, just to have it up close. And this is the one from Hourglass. And you know what? Some people had commented and asked about the ambient lighting bronzer because the promo image seemed like this new Infinity powder was a little bit deeper in tone. In fact, it looked more like a kind of like a bronzer. You know, something like more for summertime. So some people, they were like, does it look like the Radiant Bronze Light palette? And not at all. Look at this. So as you can tell, the difference is just like day and night. Okay, friends, and you know that I film here in natural light. Now, obviously, I have a big screen door in front of me. I will also take you outside.
Hey, friends, I have you here in all natural light, with the sun heating down my face, and here's how it looks like. Finishing powder, my makeup, and everything. I mean, the radiance is there. And here's the powder. Now here on the sunlight, can you see right there? Those are the little specks that I'm telling you that it has. Isn't that crazy? Yeah, so well, hopefully this view also helps you.
Okay, friends, and now into my final thoughts right here. Okay, you know that I love finishing powders, mostly those who give me some radiance to it. And this one has given me that radiance. And when I you know, said that it had some specks of glitter, believe me, they are not obvious at all and whatsoever. It actually, you know, like give a beautiful finish to my skin, but I will have to say, give a very slight, like I said, like a foggy cast. I mean, you can say yes, it's a soft focus effect, but what I'm afraid of, I don't want to repeat myself, is that it may be one of those products that is borderline, like if you are a little bit deeper than my skin tone or fair skin tone, this may not work its best. I really hope that Hourglass comes out with different shades of these because, I mean, you know, hello, we are all made different. We all have different skin tones, we all have different needs, we all have different likes, and it's about time to cater to everybody. You know, even sometimes when I do reviews here on my channel and I know a certain product doesn't offer, you know, all the shade range that, you know, should have to begin with, it frustrates me. At the same time, I want to make sure I bring the review for those who are, you know, like really wanting to see a feedback on the product, but at the same time, it hurts my heart because it's just like, you know, we all come in different colors. So hello. So that's my only thing right there. I think that perhaps it may give you a little bit of a cast if you are, again, darker than my skin tone. In fact, it reminds me a little, and I have it right here, to this Laura Mercier, the Candle Glow Sheer Perfecting Powder. And I'm gonna go ahead and swatch it, and mostly to the loose one, to the loose version. And if you have been following me for any point in time from the very beginning, you know that I love this powder. But I also know that this powder right here is not for everybody because, again, of the tone. I mean, it's very specific, you know, it's not quote unquote universal. And we know there's nothing universal about these powders. You know what? I should have swatched them with this one. Let me go back to this. Okay, so I'm gonna go here with the one from Hourglass. Then I'm gonna do this, the Laura Mercier. This is in the number 2. Yep. This is a little bit warmer. The number two is a little bit warmer, but if you have the number one, you may find it similar. And then I have here the loose one too, like I said. It's gonna look so much like the loose one. You'll see right now. Hold on, let me show you. This has a little bit more glow to this. And that's what I'm saying. This is not super, super radiant. Okay, friends. So I think this is my short video right here. I don't know how short it is, but I think this is a short video right here. I hope that you really enjoyed it, that you find it informative and helpful. I would love to read your comments down below. If you were able to get your hands on this new product from Hourglass, how are you liking it? Also, it will be helpful if you leave your skin tone, because that will help other friends from our community and our family members here to know perhaps this is for me or perhaps it's not, you know, and that way we can help each other. I greatly appreciate those comments once again. And while you're at it, and if you haven't done so yet, I hope that you will consider and subscribe to my channel, ring that post notification bell so you don't miss any of my uploads, and come and follow me on my Instagram. And obviously, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, also share with family and friends. And until the next time, I hope you have a beautiful, wonderful day. Bye.